daily dose of fantasy hockey talk, and for that, we welcome in Pete Jensen. Pete, let's start at my favorite place, the waiver wire. Who do you like there this week?
Miro Heiskanen, Dallas Stars. He's a rookie defenseman. He's on a 36-point pace right now because he has been turning it on lately. He has an assist in four of his past five games. And the big development here, reason to add him in all fantasy formats, John Klingberg's out for at least the next 4 weeks. So that thrusts Heiskanen into the first power play role with Jamie Benn, Tyler Seguin, and Alexander Radulov, who returned in Dallas's last game, scored a goal, assisted by Heiskanen. Great development there. Big minutes, as you see, from Heiskanen at 19 years old. So I'm really excited about this opportunity in the short term and how we could translate it to the long term as well. Big surprise here for Tom Wilson. His suspension's been reduced. He's coming back Tuesday night against the Minnesota Wild, playing top line, usual spot with Alex Ovechkin and Evgeny Kuznetsov. You love what he did in the playoffs. I was excited about him coming into the year. 15 points in 21 playoff games, Caps won it all. He has a chance to, if he stays disciplined, provide great category coverage and a touch of scoring for fantasy owners. Gustav Nyquist, 7-game point streak for the Detroit Red Wings, playing with Andreas Athanasiou, who just came back with a bang, 2 straight multi-point games for Athanasiou. So keep an eye on that line. And then as we look to injured goalies around the league and opportunities knocking, Casey DeSmith and Chad Johnson are both pushing hard to Matt Murray and Jake Allen, respectively, 2 fantasy duds to this point in the season. And each of those two guys starting 3 straight games, including DeSmith, getting the 3rd straight nod Tuesday night against the New Jersey Devils.
And you mentioned injuries there. We seem to just have more and more every single week, but we also have players returning. So what's the latest on the injury front?
Yeah, Andre Kasha, I'm excited to see what he can do for the Anaheim Ducks, who have been dealing with injury. He made a season debut on Monday, had 4 shots on goal, played on a line with Adam Henrique and Nick Ritchie. That was the line on the 3rd line last year that he played on, scored 20 goals in 66 games. He has a chance to have an uptick with Corey Perry still injured, and also Patrick Eves dealing with another injury now. He missed the game on Monday. Colin White, I'm excited about him as well. He's playing top line. He sustained an injury on Sunday, but Colin White was playing top line with fellow rookie Brady Tkachuk and Mark Stone, who's been outstanding in fantasy. And Colin White right now, very quietly, 2nd among rookies in points behind Elias Pettersson. And James Van Riemsdyk also on the mend for a Flyers power play unit that is fourth worst in the NHL right now. And then Jack Campbell, the Kings can't catch a break with their goalie injuries. 2 similar injuries to 2 different goalies. They're top number 1 and 2. So take a look at Peter Budaj there. Hopefully he can bring some help as a streaming option if you're a Quick or a Campbell owner.
You got to feel bad for Jack Campbell, too. Finally gets a chance to show what he's got. Played really well, and now he has to sit out for at least the next few weeks. All right, daily fantasy, what do you like for tonight's action in the NHL Tuesday night?
So Nico Hischier, star number 1 center for the Devils, he's out. So Travis Zajac enters the situation. Interesting note about Taylor Hall. No player in the NHL has more points against the Pittsburgh Penguins over the past 2 seasons than Taylor Hall.
Wow.
So look for Travis Zajac maybe to get a splash of that. His price is decent. So I'm rolling with Travis Zajac either as my number 2 center or number 1 if you're going cheap. Sam Reinhart was moved back to the top line with Jack Eichel and Jeff Skinner, one of the best lines in the NHL. Had a multi-point game in the 3rd period against the Canucks on Saturday. Multi-point games in 3 of his past 4. So Reinhart is a must-own player in season-long formats. And then in DFS, lineup lock at 4,900. Ryan Pulock, interesting development for the Islanders. They're switching up their power play units ahead of this game against the Vancouver Canucks, who are on the 2nd of a back-to-back. So Ryan Pulock is going to be on the 1st power play with Nick Leddy, Josh Bailey, Anders Lee. Barzal might be on the 2nd, but still nice to see Pulock get a bump here. He has 1 goal on 30 shots on goal, so I expect an eventual bounce back for him. He has a big shot. Mikko Koskinen starting at home for the Oilers against the Montreal Canadiens. Winnable game for them and another bounce back spot for Edmonton. They've lost 4 in a row. You expect some desperation. Koskinen's only home start this year. He's played well on the road. Only home start was that 40 save shutout against the not a early big deal. In the season. So really big opportunity for him to get the ship turned in the right direction. And then Colton Sissons for the Nashville Predators. Victor Arvidsson, tough break. He came back from injury the other day, sustained a different injury. Now he's on the shelf again on IR. So Sissons is on that top line with Philip Forsberg and Ryan Johansson. He has at least 3 shots on goal in each of his past 4 games, including that hat trick where he really broke the slate a couple of games ago. So invest in Colton Sissons for very cheap with great lineup placement for one of the best teams in the league.
Yeah, and hoping he can carry that hat trick momentum as far as he can. All right, obviously we're coming off Hall of Fame night in the NHL. It's a star-studded affair, but for you, who really stood out as somebody you were excited to go in?
Yeah, Marty Brodeur. I mean, what a great story to see him go in. And really for this Devils team for the 15, 20 years that he was there, just amazing results in terms of championships. His fantasy results, I mean, I loved his Hall of Fame speech. I loved seeing the guys that were responsible for it there. He was thanking all of them. There was Lamorello, Scott Stevens, Niedermeyer, Ken Danico. So really nice to see that. But from a fantasy standpoint, arguably in NHL history, nobody ever has played the goalie position better than Marty Brodeur. And I look back to that 06-07 season where he had 48 wins, NHL record, and he also played 78 of their 82 games that year. That is unheard of. That type of stuff may never happen again in the NHL. So hats off to Brodeur. He was my big takeaway from Monday night.